Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. My name is Mohammad Habibullah bin Ahmad Yasin, and this is Muhammad Ashkul Islam. This is one Nur Syafiqah binti Muhammad, and the last one is Nur Syafiqah binti Ahmad. Without wasting any time, let us start.
Hello everyone, this is our integrated design project IDP poster, and it's entitled with a farmer companion transporter. So for this project, I would be describing about overall introduction and then methodology section and the survey we have conducted. And the end, we will be discussing overall project. Let's move to the introduction. Transport is a crucial factor in improving agricultural productivity. Focusing on farmer companion transporter with effective multi-purpose towing rigs, the customized motor wheelbarrow is an effective and timeless tool that helps people transport heavy load with additional towing option. Furthermore, it has sustainable solar energy panel design itself. Since agricultural production is very important to the economy of developing nation as a whole, and Malaysia in particular, this improved design will encourage farmer to increase production, add value to their products, reduce spoilage and wastage, empower the farmer, as well as having positive impact on their productivity, income and employment. According to the government database, in 2020, the agricultural sector contributed 7.1%, which is roughly 101.5 billion Malaysian ringgit to the overall GDP in 2019. And palm oil industry was the highest among other livestock, fishing and other industries. So let's move to the methodology section. We have divided into five steps. So first step, we had to identify the problem, and we find out the manual loaders are too small to be carried large load quantities and lack of automation in the design to operate. So after finding this problem, we moved to the market survey. We interviewed the power agriculture factory workers and conducted survey to fulfill the requirement in designing the farmer companion transporter. After that, we moved to generate the ideas and finalize our design. So we had brainstorming session and we finalized the idea based on conceptual embodiment and detailed design. After that, we move to our step four, which is prototype designing. And then we design the customized wheelbarrow on CATIA software. After that, we had to simulate the design. So let's move to the why our product is better than others. So it provide in the design, it provide better shade system. It has stability, which has a bigger tire, which will absorb most of the shock itself on the road. And it has large towing compartment, which you can add more loads so that it can be carried out easily. And then it has time saver, epicyclic gear, which gives us maximum torque within minimum power. Let's move to the market survey. We conducted a survey and analyzed the problem regarding existing wheelbarrows or loaders, and evaluate the customer requirements regarding the productivity of the customized wheelbarrow We focus on 40 respondents, which are from power agricultural industries for this project. So let's come to the point. What is the overall design discussion? What's the outcome? So our design capable to carry large load quantities with the extended towing option, capable to sustain the extreme condition of Malaysian hot weather and reduce manpower and increase work efficiency. Although the customized wheelbarrow is designed for agricultural and industrial purpose, however, it can also be used in our daily life activities like move to daily goods and can bring to the supermarket as well. The transporter can operate on rusty and sloppy road condition as well. It has sustainable solar power design along with electrical battery system. It can operate all day long, and at night it can provide up to 6 hours operating time. And above all, the customized wheelbarrow design is agronomic, environmental, and user-friendly. Thank you.
Next, I will be presenting about the innovative solution for the sustainable design. So what is a sustainable design? By following through the Wikipedia, sustainable design is a philosophy of designing physical objects, the built environment, and services to comply with the principle of ecological sustainability. In short, sustainable design can also be called as a eco-friendly design. So what makes our product sustainable? So in the early development process of this product, the product utilizes a computerized design software such as CATIA, SOLIDWORKS, and ANSYS. By using this software, it is able to assist the development of the product and including the performing the analysis on the finalized product design. By using this software also, it saves time and cost as the product don't need to have to be fully made until then perform the analysis. So, by using this software also, the parameter can easily be altered to suit the product needs such as the weight loaded on the transporter. As you can see in the figure, there are 6 components that mainly build this transporter. This transporter is powered by 2 methods. First is a rechargeable battery and second is by using a solar panel. Rechargeable battery are function to power the scissor object during the unloading of the load from using the towing tray, and secondly is to power the engine motor to drive the transporter. For the working hour of this battery, it able to provide a sufficient operating time for the driving, that is 6 hours and 24 minutes. For the detailed calculation for this working hour of the battery, you can refer to the report. So, to charge the battery is attached to the power socket in order to recharge it. Next is the battery capacity calculation. We assume the medium size farm has a total distance trip of 6 km times 6 street. So we obtain an 8 km. We will calculate the total travel time with the formula D equal to D over V, distance over velocity. And finally, we obtain the T is equal to 0.45 hour. Next, we calculate also the total energy that should be supplied by the motor and the maximum energy that should be applied by the battery. Next, we calculate the battery capacity needed. Assuming the battery efficiency is 90% and the maximum allowed depth of discharge DOD is 80%, our chosen battery is a battery voltage 12 volt, and the battery capacity is at 30 Ah. So battery capacity, we're using the formula, and then we obtain that the battery capacity is 20.25 Ah. So by referring to this value, it's lower than our chosen battery, so it's a suitable battery to be used. Next is a solar panel. Solar panel is built in this for this transporter to utilize the Malaysia's sunlight and daytime. In average, Malaysia receives 2028 hours sunlight per year. So sunlight is also a renewable energy. Also, this solar panel function to provide shade to the user, and this make the transporter do not rely solely to the charged battery. So during a long drive and the battery is dropping, we can use the solar panel to generate the energy for the transporter. So what we achieve with the implementation of this system? So by referring back to our house of security, we able to fulfill two customer requirements by implementing these two systems. That is a sufficient operating hours that our transporter can operate for 6 hours and 24 minutes, and also is a safe time. So that's all for me. I will pass to the next presenter.
Syafiqah, and I'm going to explain about the process economics in entrepreneurship for our project. So the first highlighted thing is the cost estimation of our project. Based on the bill of material, where we have listed every part price, the cost of goods or part is about 1,853 ringgit and 4 cents. So the price of complete product that we would like to sell is about 2,500 ringgit. So if we calculate the gross profit, it would be 646 ringgit and 96 cents for each complete product or prototype. So for the first goal, we would like to sell 100 units of complete product or prototype to users. Since we put the price for one unit of product is 2,500 ringgit, therefore for 100 units it will be 250,000 ringgit. However, the cost of goods for 100 unit would be 185,304 ringgit. Therefore, the gross profit would be 64,696 ringgit. Next, part that I want to highlight is two customized parts that makes this transporter special from other existing transporter. The first custom part is for wheel. We use epicyclic gear train. An epicyclic gear train system was used because of its compactness, where it can easily fit into the hub of the wheel, and it also able to generate a higher output torque from the input motor. From the material selection, electrical motorized kit that has been chosen is the fourth choice, which is electric bicycle engine kit with customized epicyclic gear train. The cost for electric bicycle engine kit is 300 ringgit, while custom epicyclic gear train is to RM29.99. This combination makes it cheaper than others and also due to addition of custom-made epicyclic gear train, the engine power will be powerful than the other kit. The second custom part is J-anchor for towing mechanism. A customized J-anchor bolt was selected because it can work without requiring any nuts, since we use a charger port concept where a mild steel J-anchor bolt added with yellow zinc plated treatment that has a 12.98mm radius, just need to be plugged in through the two connectors to keep the transporter and the dump box in place. This also has high durability, anti-corrosion convenient, and able to support our external dump box, since it can support up to 13,000 Newton force. This proven by doing some force analysis in solid work. So the red part shows where the first failure can happen, and the blue one shows where it impossible to fail. As in a force analysis diagram, it has only a small area with red parts, so we can see that it is strong enough to support up to 13,000 Newton force. That's all for my part. Thank you.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Our group are actually trying our best to apply a concept where we can eliminate as much as possible from any energy waste. One of it is by using solar panel system. So from our observation, since Malaysia has a natural tropical weather with average daily solar radiation of 4,500 kWh per meter, are actually more than enough to allow us to use solar panel to generate electricity for our product, which had been proven by a researcher made by postdoctoral Abdul Aziz and his teammate. Our solar panel consists of 6 main components, as we can see from here, which consists of tempered glass, aluminum frame, solar cell, junction box, back sheet, and 2 layers of EVA and encapsulant, which was created by using SolidWorks 2020. This solar panel was then simulated by using NC software to perform the Philip element analysis to study the heat transfer to the back sheet of the solar panel. PVF material was used as the back sheet of our solar panel because of its high performance. So this is the result of our analysis with the maximum temperature occur on the tempered glass with temperature up to 141 Celsius, while the minimum temperature is on the aluminum frame is up to 65.912 Celsius. This animation was run up to 4-second loop with 20 fps frame rate. Since the main function of our photovoltaic solar cell is to absorb the solar radiation, so we can prove that this solar panel is fully functioning and can be used in our product, because as shown in the display, the hottest region, which is the red mark, lands exactly on our photovoltaic solar cell. So we choose this battery with 12 volt and 30 ampere. This battery has a larger capacity than other except for this one. However, the size of the battery must be suitable to fit in our battery port design. Since the size of this battery is quite big, thus this battery does not suitable for our transporter. Besides that, the 12 volt and 30 ampere battery has a suitable weight of 1.5 kg. The weight of battery must not be too heavy to save power and energy. But however, the battery also cannot be too light, so that we can have stability to plus water. The most suitable tray and dump box material that can be used is aluminium. Why? Because it has high compression strength and tensile strength compared to plastic and canvas. Moreover, aluminium is lighter than stainless steel, so that it will consume less energy when moving. In order to avoid rusting, we will apply coating on it. While stainless steel would be the best material to use for our towing rig and platform, as it has high tensile strength compared to other material. Stainless steel has a quite long lifespan, which can up to 50 years. The thermal conductivity of stainless steel is relatively low. So we can conclude that aluminium will be the best material for our portable dump box and tray, as it has low price range compared to stainless steel. The electric bicycle engine kit would be the best kit for us to use to our transporter, because it comes with thumb throttle, battery indicator and acceleration button switch. It is also cost effective solution, as it has a lower price than another three electric motorized kit. Moreover, we create our custom-made epicyclic gear train, as we can see in this simulation test, with fixed sun carrier as the input, while the ring will be the output. As we can see from this sensor graphical graph, we can conclude that our simulation is a success, since the RPM of the output ring was higher than the input carrier. Thus, a higher amount of torque from the motor input can be delivered to the drive wheel. Moreover, we also use big tire for all the wheel, so that it can absorb greater impact from the ground for safety and comfort purpose. Our epicyclic gear train can be embedded into the hub of rim, so it will be more pretty, and because they cannot see the engine. So that's all from us. Thank you very much.